Welcome to Cleaves Tech and another video in our Focus for Stable Diffusion series of videos. In this video, I'll be going over the basics of outpainting with Fooocus. Outpainting with Fooocus allows you to take an image and expand it. Think of it like zooming out from the original image so you can see what is around the edges. Now, with this video, I will assume you already have Fooocus installed and know the basic features. If you need information on those things, I do have other videos in the series that covers all of that and will include those in the description. I will also be running it with the default run.bat and settings unless I show otherwise. So first thing I'm going to do is actually just generate an image. I'm going to use quality settings, 1024 by 1024. Everything else is the basic settings with the run.bat file. So I'll go ahead, hit generate. I have a prompt, a cat on a couch in a living room. I'll hit generate. Okay, so we've got our two cats generated. Now, one thing I do want to mention is if you go to use these features first, the first time, it may take longer when you hit that generate button to actually for it to start working. The reason for that is it does download models in the background if you haven't used them before. Fooocus doesn't actually install those right off. They are only downloaded once you go to use them. So just keep that in mind. You can always go into the command prompt window and you can always look to see what's going on there. If for any reason it doesn't seem to be doing anything, go in there, look and see what's happening. I have my two images. I'm actually gonna use the one on the right only because it looks like my cat I had as a kid. Once we're ready to do that, we're gonna hit the input image down below here and we're gonna go to the inpaint or outpaint tab. And at this point, we're just gonna drag that image down here to the bottom. I do want to mention you don't have to do just dragging from the top. You can bring in other images you've already generated. Then you have in the bottom the outpaint direction. These are the settings, the only settings really for the outpaint that you need to know. Everything else that's in here is for inpainting. So you have left, right, top, and bottom. Left means it expands the image to the left, right to the right, top, and then bottom. Keep in mind, this will change the resolution of the image. It actually adds to it. It doesn't change the original image. So when you add to the left, it actually will increase the width of the image. When you add to the right, same thing, top and bottom. One thing I do recommend is only doing one of these at a time. You can do them all at once and expand it. My problem with that is you'll find that a lot of times you don't like the results of left, right, top, or bottom. So let's say you do all four of them and then you don't like two of them. Well, it's going to be a lot easier if you just do one step at a time. And from my understanding, from what I've read, I haven't tested this fully. People say that you get better results one at a time. So let's go ahead on this one. I'm just going to add to the left at the moment. I'll check off left, and then I'm just going to go ahead and back up here and generate. I could change the prompt if I wanted to add something to that as well as it expands. But for this, I'm going to leave it the same, because I just wanted to fill in the living room. Okay, so we have our two images generated. Looks kind of funky with the tail. It may be confusing the tail with a leg. I'm not sure, but I'm not going for perfection here. One thing I do want to point out that you will, and this is one of the important things to keep an eye on, that can be sometimes fixed later in inpainting or with some other tools, but you will sometimes see a seam on these images. So for this one, for example, down here, you can actually, I can see the seam where it is. But now, of course, I also know where that was. Normally, I might not notice that if I was just looking at this image. This one's a little bit better. Doesn't have the seam. Of course, this, the tail, that looks kind of weird. So I'm actually going to use this one. It's not bad. I don't really notice it that much. If I was doing this for more for my own purposes, for a perfect picture, I probably would just generate more. But for the video, I'm not going to go ahead and do that. So we're going to use that image here. Now, remember, you want to drag this one down, the new image, because if you forget to and you hit the generate again, you're just going to generate new images. Now, we're going to uncheck left. We're going to check right, because now I want to add to the right of this image. And I'll go ahead and hit generate again. Okay, so our right-hand side has now been generated. Yeah, you can still see this one. You can definitely see there's a difference in the pattern. This one, there is a slight I can notice in a couple spots, but it's much more difficult to notice. So I'm going to use this one I will demonstrate at this point just to give you an example to show you this. But now you'll see that the actual resolution has been changed as we have widened the image. So it's become, so it hasn't changed the central image. It's just adding on to it. It's not resizing, rescaling, or anything like that with the outpainting. It's literally just adding to one side, top or bottom, when you do that. Now we'll go ahead and I'm actually gonna now add to the, I'm gonna do the top and the bottom at the same time on this one, just to show you that it can be done. Yeah. Okay. Top and bottom, we're gonna use this image here. You gotta remember to drag it down. Otherwise, you're gonna risk regenerate. Now, if you were to do that, hit the generate, you can always go back, pull the image in from your folder and just drag it down there. It's not a total loss. Now we're gonna go ahead and generate from this. Like I said, it's gonna add to the top and bottom at this point. Okay, so we've expanded the top and bottom, and this is actually gonna show you what I'm trying to, one of the things I wanna explain here of why I don't like doing the top and bottom at the same time. Because what can happen is, let's say you like the top, but you don't like the bottom, you'll have to regenerate or edit the photo. By doing one section at a time, you can pick and choose. Now, as you can see in this image, see there is a seam. There's also this down here, it didn't get perfect, but you get the idea of how the outpaint works. Just like regular image generation, you're gonna have to do a bunch of different ones. It's not gonna always come out great. You will get images that do come out good and then other ones that don't. A lot of trial and error and just keep generating. Okay, just one last example I'm gonna show, just to give an idea of how it works. I feel that if I do the all around, it gives a more clearer picture of how everything works. So let's go ahead. I have this image that I created before. We're gonna do left, right, top, bottom, just for this example. Now, in this, I'm gonna put an ancient soldier standing in a dungeon with chains on the wall. Just wanna demonstrate how this will try to take what the image is and expand using the prompt that we've added. So let's go ahead and see what happens. Okay, so we have our images, and of course, it didn't add chains to one of them, but that's what to expect from Stable Diffusion. It doesn't always want to listen to what you tell it. But that gives you an idea of how, by adding to the prompt, I was able to expand that and take that image and create more with it. Well, that pretty much covers the basics of outpainting. Now, just for fun, I'm going to go ahead and expand this one more time. If you found this video helpful, please do consider clicking the like button because it does help. I will have a video on inpainting coming out very soon. I've actually started working on it and I was gonna be combining it with this video, but I've decided to break them into two different videos. And any questions or suggestions for video ideas, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching. And don't forget that I do have other videos on Fooocus and I will have more in the future. And have a great day.